Hariyam, dear students, let's start a second part of the sixth lesson, that is 100 results 2. Yes, children, the previous part we have ended with Mary taking a conclusion that she will never entertain any other students teasing one another just by the sake of a funny name or being a foreigner or coming from a very poor area. So she had taken a strong determination, though she loses a Peggy's friendship or whatever may happen, she will never entertain such kind of a bullying or teasing or picking. That was the conclusion which was taken in the previous part by Mary. So now let us see what will happen now. So on Saturday, Mary spent that afternoon with Peggy. That means both of them had spent together on the last day of the week, and they thought of writing a letter to Wanda Patransky about the competition and how Wanda Patransky had won the contest and how her drawings were really beautiful. If you just see here, on Sunday, Mary spent the afternoon with Peggy. They were writing a letter to Wanda Patransky. So both of them thought of writing a letter to Wanda Patransky, just telling, it was a friendly letter, that they were feeling very bad about their behavior, how they have treated Wanda Patransky, isn't it? So here in this letter, they wanted to convey all their concern for Wanda Patransky. So they have discussed about the contest, and also they said that how she had won. Who had won the competition here? Wanda Patransky had won the drawing and painting contest, and how all her drawings were just kept for a show in the classroom to all the windowsills and all. And they also have said that all her drawings were really pretty, and in that way they wanted to say that they were not so rude to the they were not so rude to this Wanda Patransky. And also they have asked whether she likes her new place where she is living now, because now Wanda Patransky had moved from Boggins Height to the new big city. Even here Peggy and Mary don't know where she had moved to. So they were asking whether she likes the new place and whether she likes the new teacher where she had joined the school. So in that way they wanted to say that they were really sorry for what they have done. They had meant to say that they were really sorry. That means they have treated her very rudely by asking again and again repeatedly how many dresses she had and how many pairs of shoes she had. All these things, they were feeling guilty of their words and their behavior towards Wanda Patransky. And after writing this friendly letter, just with lots of love, they have signed the letter and saying that it is lots of love. That means with a lot of love they have written it, and they just mailed the letter. That means they have posted the letter to Boggins Height. Is Wanda Patransky staying at Boggins Height? No, already they have moved. But on the envelope they have written that, please forward the letter to Wanda Patransky wherever she is staying. So in that way they somehow feel relaxed and free of that guiltiness that they have just picked Wanda Patransky by the name of 100 dresses. So somehow they have written a letter and they have posted to Boggins Height, and they were expecting a reply from Wanda Patransky here. And days passed, but there was no answer. So when they are expecting a reply from Wanda Patransky, they didn't get any reply from Wanda Patransky. But they were sure that the letter reached Wanda Patransky, because the letter didn't come back to them. Let us say when you just do a register post or some important couriers, when the person to whom you are addressing, if the person didn't get it, the particular letter will return back to the sender, isn't it? So here Peggy and Mary didn't return that sorry, didn't get that letter back. That means they thought that Wanda Patransky had received the letter. Perhaps she was so hurt and she was so angry that she don't want to answer the letter. Okay, that is what they were feeling. She was so bad. She was so hurt because of the behavior of both of them, like Maddie and Peggy. That's why she's not interested to reply for the letter. That is what they are thinking. Weeks passed and days passed, but they didn't get any reply from Wanda. Like, no, just when they have written such a letter, they were expecting a reply from Wanda, but still Wanda did not answer for the letter which was written by Peggy and Maddie. And after weeks, Peggy had forgotten all these things and started her own business. Like, no, she was busy with her studies, friends and everything. She had forgotten about Wanda Patransky and all the business about her, like how they have mistreated her, all these things she had forgotten. But coming to Maddie, she couldn't forget that. And in the sleep at night, she started making speeches about Wanda. Like, no, even in our dreams, we do speak sometimes in mid of the sleep. And even when we don't even remember, like, what do we speak? Like, when the people who sleep beside us, they'll be saying, like, our mom or dad, hey, what are you speaking in the night? You have spoken so and so words. They'll be saying, and we really feel wonder, have we spoken those words? So in the same way here, though Peggy had forgotten everything about Wanda Patransky and all the business, but Maddie here, she couldn't forget Wanda Patransky and what had happened with her. And it was in her mind, which was so deeply picked, man, she couldn't forget. And in the sleep, okay, in the mid of the sleep, she started making speeches about Wanda. Like, you know how these 100 girls while sleeping in the crowds of girls in the ground, when they were trying to tease Wanda, like how many dresses she is having, and suddenly she could go there and ask to stop, and she used to shout at everyone. Maddie used to cry out, stop, what are you doing? So in this way, she used to dream about Wanda Patransky, and also used to shout a lot in mid of the sleep, because no, she had still, she's feeling the pain in the heart that she was one of the girl who is responsible for Wanda Patransky's movement out of the school. That is only because of them she left the school. And all these things had really worried Maddie a lot, and every day she used to think about Wanda Patransky in the sleep, and she used to say that, oh no, hey girl, stop it, why are you teasing her? And she could feel like, no, how Wanda could press her lips together in a tight line, and she puts a lot of hesitation to answer to the questions which were asked by the group of the girls. So all this situation, she used to dream every day, Maddie, and she used to say, stop, and never, don't tease the girls again in this way. So somehow, then after this, everyone would feel ashamed of their behavior and stop teasing Wanda Patransky. So this was the dream every day Maddie used to dream. Like, no, Wanda Patransky, when she was in the ground, a group of girls used to ask her about the 100 dresses, and she couldn't answer and press her lips very tightly and feel so uncomfortable, and she hesitated to speak. At that time, Maddie used to come there and say, hey, stop, what are you doing? And then all the other girls who were trying to tease her or poke her used to feel ashamed of their behavior. This was the dream which Maddie used to get every day. So like this, the days are passing, and finally now it was the time of Christmas, and there was a snow on the ground everywhere. We all know that in most of the foreign countries, during Christmas or December, January, it snows a lot. And Christmas bells and small trees were decorated in the classrooms. So they were having a pre-celebrations in the class on just before the day of Christmas. And on the last day of the school before the holidays, the teacher showed the class a letter she had received that morning. So just before the school get closed, just before the holidays, the last working day, everyone have gathered and they were having a Christmas celebrations in the school. And on that day, the teacher, who is the teacher here? Miss Mason, she came to the class and she had shown a letter which she had received on that day morning. So now let us see what is the letter and who had written that letter and to whom it is addressing. Yes, the letter is from Wanda Petronsky. So she, here Miss Mason, the teacher, is saying that, yeah, you, do you remember Wanda Petronsky, the little girl who was a very good artist who had won the drawing contest? So she had written a letter to me. So Miss Mason, the teacher, is saying all these things. So, dear children, do you know the girl whose name is Wanda Petronsky, who had won the drawing competition, who was really very good artist? Yeah, I hope you have remembered her. She had written a letter to me and I'm very happy, glad in the sense, I'm very happy that now I know where does she live, because she wanted to send her medal, which was not taken by Wanda Petronsky, because by the time of announcement of the contest result, she had already left the school, isn't it? On Thursday or Friday, the results were announced, but she was not coming to school from Monday onwards, isn't it? So she didn't collect her medal, and now this Miss Mason is very happy that she wanted to, she can send this medal to Wanda Petronsky, because she now came to know of where this Wanda Petronsky lives. So now she is reading that letter to all the students in the classroom. So everyone started listening very carefully with a lot of interest. So now let us read the letter which was written by Wanda Petronsky. Dear Miss Mason, how are you? And Room 13, please tell the girls they can keep those 100 dresses, because in my new house, I have 100 new ones all lined up in my closet. I would like that girl, Peggy, to have the drawing of the green dress with the red trimming, and her friend Maddie to have the blue one for Christmas. I miss that school and my new teacher does not equalize with you. Merry Christmas to you and everybody. Yes, truly, Wanda Petronsky. So this was the letter written by Wanda Petronsky to Miss Mason. So in this lesson, you can see that there is no hatredness or angriness of Wanda Petronsky is shown here. She was so happy and she was saying that, how are you, teacher, and how are all the students in the room 13? And also she said that she is asking all the students, all the girls of the dress here, to keep the 100 dresses to themselves, because in her new house she is having a 100 new ones now. That means she had drawn another 100 dresses which were all lined up in her closet. So she is telling all the girls of room 13 to have these 100 dresses for themselves, and because she had drawn another new 100 dresses which were really very beautiful, and especially the girl Peggy to have the green dress. Already we have discussed about this green dress, which was laced and decorated with a red ribbon, and also Maddie to have this blue dress for Christmas. That was the gift which was sent by Wanda Petronsky, this Peggy to have green dress and Maddie to have blue dress. And also she said that she really misses the school where she had studied. That means the present this school where Peggy, Maddie and all of them have studied together. She's saying that she really missed that school, and the new teacher even does not really equalize this miss my son. That means I miss all of you. She's saying that she really misses the school and as well as the teachers. And finally she wished Merry Christmas to everyone. So here you can see that this letter shows her lot of love and concern towards the students and as well as the teacher here. That means she doesn't have any angry or hatredness towards the students of the school like Peggy and Matty. Yeah. After the school, on their way to home, both Matty and Peggy, just they were discussing about the Vanda Patransky and with the drawings in their hands very carefully. They were holding the drawings very carefully and they were just moving to their homes. And on their way they can see all the houses had the wreaths and holly in the windows. That means all the houses were decorated for the Christmas, and trees were the hundreds of trees were stacked. That means decorated, and even in the windows candy peppermint sticks were there. That means you can see candies, chocolate sticks were there, like lollipops and corn copies of a shiny transparent papers were strung like stars, and different decorations were made all over the trees and windows and the homes, and everything seemed to be really great Christmas. And even the air is smelling like Christmas here, and everything seemed really the feeling of Christmas had come to them now, because their hearts are filled with happiness because they have received a letter from Vanda Patransky. And now Peggy said, hey boy, just listen. That means when this Vanda Patransky, when she had given these drawings, that means that this shows that she really likes us, and also she got our letter. That means already they have written a letter to Vanda Patransky, and they were worrying whether this Vanda Patransky had received the letter, or whether why then she is not replying, is she is very angry. So in that way there were many questions in Peggy and Maddie's conversation. But here now all those doubts were clarified, because this Peggy says that yeah, see now this is now we can say that this Vanda Patransky really likes us, and she had received our letter, and this is the way that she is saying that everything is all right. That means there is no hatredness or angriness towards both the girls. That's it. That means everything is over. So now we can feel free that because of us she didn't leave the school. So in that way they were discussing, and even Maddie said that very sadly, yeah, I hope so, that now I feel little relaxed. But still she felt sad because she can never see this Vanda Patransky again, and she could never make the things right again. In that way somehow, though she came to know that this Vanda Patransky didn't hate them and she loves them a lot, still that pain is there in Maddie that she couldn't make the things right and she can't see Vanda Patransky anymore. And after that both of them went to home, and this Maddie, she went to home and she pinned her drawing of a blue dress to a wall in the bedroom. And the moment she pinned that picture to the wall, she felt that the total shabby room became really alive with the brilliance of colors. That means it looked, the room looked very lively, and immediately she went onto her bed and she sat down and started looking at the drawing. And she stood there by and said nothing, but Vanda had been so nice to her anyway. That means she was saying that she was a very good girl. She was she went up sorry Maddie went to home. She kept her drawing to a wall, and then she just sat on the bed and started watching at this drawing, and she was saying that, yeah, how beautiful Wanda was. She was really good. She treated all of us in a very good manner. In this way, Maddie started thinking about Wanda Patransky. When this Maddie was sitting on her bed and looking at the picture, that is the blue dress which was hanged in her room, tears blurred her eyes. That means tears were rolling on her cheeks, and she gazed for a long time at that picture. That means she was just looking, gazing in a sense, looking at that picture for a long time, and suddenly she rubbed her eyes and started looking at the picture so intently, in the sense, very closely. She started looking at the picture, and all the colors in the dress were so vivid. That means they were really different, and she had scarcely noticed that. She could hardly, scarcely in the sense, very toughly, very hardly, she could notice the face and head of the drawing. That means it looked like the drawing of the blue dress which was given to Maddie looked like as if totally of her own mouth. That means here Maddie's own picture was drawn by Wanda Patransky in that picture. So see here, it really looked like her own self. That means Maddie's picture was drawn. So Wanda had really drawn this for her. It is not that after writing an excuse letter by Peggy and Maddie, she had decided to give that pictures to them. But really, when this Wanda Patransky was in the school, she had drawn this picture for Maddie. This blue dress was drawn for Maddie. So that was really very happy moment to Maddie here, and immediately very with a lot of excitement she ran to Peggy, and Peggy, she started speaking there, let's see your picture which was given to you. And immediately they have gone to the Peggy's room, and Maddie had taken the picture which was just lie down on the bed, and she started looking at it, and she said that, yeah, look Peggy, look, she had drawn you. That's you. That is none other but, so the colors in this picture really resemble the picture of you. That means she had drawn you. And here even Peggy was very happy, and yes, the head and the face of the picture just looked like Peggy here. That means when she was there in the school itself, she had drawn those two drawings for Maddie and Peggy. And then Peggy said, yeah, what did I say? I said that she must have really liked us anyway. That means she didn't hated us. She didn't annoyed us. That is what I am saying from the beginning. She really liked us. That's why she had drawn these pictures for us. And then finally, Maddie agreed. Yes, she must have really liked us. That's why she had drawn this. And then she had just blinked her tears which were just rolling from her cheeks, and she just started thinking about Wanda, how she was standing all alone after the school in the afternoon in the schoolyard, and all the girls, how they were laughing after her, and how she used to go back. And finally she used to say, sure, 100 dresses of them are there in my cupboard. Still, those words of Wanda Patransky were in the mind of Maddie here. Yes, she really liked us, she said, and still she's thinking about Wanda Patransky, how she stood alone in the sunny hot day, and how all the girls used to make fun of him. And still she confidently says that, she said that, yes, 100 of dresses are there, and all of them are lined up in my kabut. So with this we can say that Wanda Patransky didn't annoy Peggy or Maddie, and she really loved them. That's why she had drawn those pictures for both of them. Yes, children, hope you have understood this story. Now let us get into our oral comprehension check. Here is the first question. What did girls write to Wanda? Maddie and Peggy had written a letter to Wanda saying that how beautifully her drawings were and how she had won the coloring competition, and also they really didn't mean to hurt her, and also asked her whether she likes her new school and new teacher and new surroundings, isn't it? Yeah, moving to the next question. Did they get a reply? Who was more anxious for a reply, Peggy or Maddie? How do you know? Yeah, did they get a reply? No, they didn't get a reply from Wanda Patransky, and here Peggy was not so anxious about the reply, but Maddie was very anxious about the reply. Even after the weeks passed, she was thinking about Wanda Patransky. So by this we can say that even in her sleep, Maddie used to speak about Wanda Patransky and how she was bullied in the class, and all these things we can say that Maddie was worried more about the reply from Wanda Patransky's. Yeah, moving to the third question here. How did the girls know that Wanda liked them even though they had teased her? So by seeing the pictures here, when the girl had written a letter and the blue dress was given to Maddie and green dress was given to Peggy here, by seeing the pictures, when they have analyzed that the picture was not just a normal painting, the blue dress was just drawn with the features of these Maddie and the green dress was drawn with the features of Peggy. So they finally came to know that she really liked Wanda, really liked them, and though they have teased her. Yes, children, now thinking about the text, here the first question is, why do you think Wanda's family moved to a different city? Do you think life there was going to be different for their family? Yeah, because of this discrimination or bullying, they have moved, and they were expecting really a different life will be there, because it's a big city and big schools and many people will be there and many funny names will be there. In that way, they thought that the life will be different in the big city. Maddie thought her silence was as bad as Peggy's teasing. Was she right? Yes, definitely she was right, because if she could have stopped Peggy there, Wanda Patransky might not have felt so bad about the bullying. That is what the feeling of Maddie here. So if she was also as equal as Peggy here, she was thinking that she was a coward because she had encouraged Peggy and other girls to tease Wanda Patransky by not protesting them. So in that way, she was thinking that her silence was as bad as Peggy's teasing. Yeah, moving to the third question. Peggy says, I never thought she had the sense to know we were making fun of her anyway. I thought she was too dumb and key. Look how she can draw. What led Peggy to believe that Wanda was dumb? Did she change her opinion later? Yeah, Peggy really thought that she was dumb because she had never spoken to anyone. Always she used to sit in the last bench of the class and hardly she speaks few words. And always whenever she wanted to speak, she used to just put her lips so very tight and speak in that way. Peggy thought that she was dumb. And finally, at the end, she had changed her opinion by seeing all the beautiful drawings of Wanda Patransky, and also after the letter which was received from Wanda Patransky, Peggy finally had changed her opinion. Dear children, hope you have understood this lesson. If you have any doubts, feel free to contact me or Neelima Madam, and do follow the textbook when you are listening to this video. Hari Om. Thank you.